Hello and welcome to a new Krita tutorial. This is the second part of color picker tutorial. So watch the part one first for this video to make sense, as I will be touching upon some of the things I did not talk about in the previous video. Now let's get started. In the last video, I explained the features of Palette Docker. I will now explain the rest of the features. To add a group in your palette, click on Edit this palette icon and then Add a group. A small window will pop up. Give your group a name. Change the row count if you need to. And click OK. To add a color to your group, select that color from the color selector, then click on this plus icon, select the group, and click OK. If you want to edit a color in your palette, select that color, then click on Modify the spot. You can change the color swatch name. You can also change the color present in that spot to another color. Click OK when you are done. Next option is radius. And at the moment it is at 1 pixel, which means that it is going to be super precise in sampling the color. I'm going to make two circles, one of 40 pixels and the other of 250 pixels. Then I'm going to increase the radius of the color picker to 40 pixels. Now if I try to sample the color from 40 pixel circle, I won't be able to pick the color precisely. As you can see, this is the color I want to select. But this is the color sampled by the color picker. I will have no problem sampling the color from the bigger circle, as the radius of the color picker is smaller than the radius of the circle. So keeping the radius at 1 pixel will work perfectly. Next up is blend option. This option will allow you to blend two colors together to make a new one. For now, the blend option is at 100%, which means that the color picker will sample the color completely. I will change this option to 20%. The color selected at the moment is yellow. So now I will pick blue color and then paint with it. As you can see, the shade of yellow has changed slightly. I will paint with the blend option, increasing 20% each time for you to see how the shade changes with each increment. This option can be helpful and more intuitive for artists who use traditional mediums. These are all the options related to the color picker that I wanted to explain. If you found the video helpful, leave a like and a comment. Subscribe for future videos, and I will see you next time. Bye!